So here it is told that if cos y equal to x cos a plus y, cos of a plus y, and cos a is not equal to plus minus 1, it means a is not equal to n pi, where n belongs to z. Z is the set of all integers. Then we have to prove that dy by dx that is equal to cos square a plus y by sine a. So from here we can write x will be equal to cos y by cos of a plus y. And then if we take the derivative of both sides with respect to y, then this will be dx by dy, that will be equal to d by dy of cos y by cos of a plus y. So that will be equal to, so here we have to apply the quotient rule. So this will be cos of a plus y into d by dy of cos y minus cos y into d by dy of cos of a plus y. Here a is a constant actually. A is a constant, but y and x, these are variables. So that divided by cos square a plus y. So then therefore dx by dy, that will be equal to cos of a plus y into minus sine y, then minus cos y into, this will be minus sine of a plus y. Minus sine of a plus y by cos square a plus y. So this we can write it as, so minus into minus will be plus. So this will be cos y into sine of a plus y. So sine of a plus y into cos y minus, I can write sine y into cos of a plus y divided by cos square of a plus y. So therefore this dx by dy, that can be written as, this is sine a cos b minus cos a sine b. So this is sine of a minus b. So this is sine of a plus y minus y. So divided by cos square of a plus y. So y and y will cancel. So this is sine a. So dx by dy, that is coming sine a by cos square a plus y. So now if we take the reciprocals on both sides, then we will get dy by dx, that will be equal to cos square a plus y divided by sine a. So hope you have understood. So hence proved. Thank you.